द्वितीयभागः रामायणभागः सुन्दरकाण्डभागः. टुडे इस् अगेन् एप्रिल् 9th साटर्डे. सो लेट्स् डू द मङ्गलाचरणम्. थिङ्क् वसु म्यूट् यूर्सेल्फ् वसु. मङ्गलाचरणं. रामो राजमणिः सदा विजयते, रामं रमेशं भजेऽहम्. रामेणाभिहता निशाचरचमो रामाय तस्मै नमः. रामान्नास्ति परायणं परतरं, रामश्च दासोऽस्म्यहम्. रामे चित्तरेस्तदा भवतु मे भो राम मामुद्धर. राम रामेति रामेति रमे रामे मनोरमे. सहस्रनामतत्तुल्यं राम नाम वरानने, श्रीराम नाम वरानन ओं नम इति. बलराम जी सर. बलराम जी
नमस्ते. नमस्ते जी.
लास्ट टाइम व्हिच वन वी डू इज लिस्ट एंड लास्ट टाइम तथैव. I think it was the last thing we did last time, is it right?
I think we stopped at Agachat. Just before that.
Niragachat.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do this one now. Again, this is a long, long adhyaya. It has more than 200 verses. So, I mean, going forward, we'll have the Sankshipta Varnanam only like one line and two lines, maybe mostly one line only. But this adhyaya has more than 200 verses. So that's why we'll be a bit patient. It's like really, this is like four or five adhyayas taken together. We won't have this long summary every time, no. You'll only have like one or two lines and that'll be it. Okay, let's do the next line now. Tathaiva simhikachya nicharim mukham vyadaya yasitum paripalayantim svikrita sukshma dehastaduram pravishya vidarana purvakam vyapadayat. So tathaiva Simhikakhya Nicharim, it's a compound word. Mukham Vyadaya Grasitum Paripalayantim Svikrita Sukshmadehastarudaram Pravishya Vidharanapurvakam Vyapadayata. So do you want to Pradishya for Ravi? Pradishya for Ravi? Try that. Tatha.
Eva.
Eva.
सिंहिकाख्यनिच्चरीम्
समस्तपदं सिंहिकाख्यनिच्चरीम् ओके.
मुखं
मुखं
व्यादाय
व्यादाय
ग्रसितुं
ग्रसितुं
प्रतिपालयन्तीं
प्रतिपालयन्तीं
स्वीकृतसूक्ष्मदेहः
वेरि गुड् स्वीकृतसूक्ष्मदेहः
तदुदरं
तदुदरं
प्रविश्य
प्रविश्य
विदारणपूर्वकं
Purvakam.
Vyapadayat.
Vyapadayat. The interesting thing here, first of all, Ravi made the compound tadudaram. Whenever you have a word which is declined form and undeclined form is the same, then you have this confusion whether it is samastapadam atva putakpadam. Samas antargatam padam astiva, putakpadam astiva. Tad udaram. You know, tad could have been a putakpadam, means that. Can be dvitiya or prathama ekavachanam of the napumsakalinga pratipadikam in means pronoun shabda, it's a pronoun, napumsakalinga. That stomach. In fact, you could nicely qualify udaram. So Ravi made the compound which is correct because tasya udaram. Tasya, so nicharyaha udaram. Means her stomach, not that stomach, but hers. Anyway, there's a choice. So whenever, in fact, as you saw in the first half of the class today, is that any avyayam takes supluk. So now you do not know whether it's part of the samasa or not. In fact, just this morning in our Gita class, we're looking at this form in chapter 14 of Gita. So this is something you should keep in mind. You should keep in mind that this thing can happen. Whenever there is a form which is declined, undeclined, the same, then you have this situation. So in Gita, today we had Bhagavad Gita in chapter 14, we had this form, Kimacharha. One of my favorite examples of this phenomenon, where you can have a Sandehaha, Vikalpaha, Samasa Asti Vanava. So in Gita chapter 14, कैलिङ्गैस्त्रीन् गुणान् एतान् अतीत भवति प्रभो किमाचारः कथं चैतान्. trin gunan ati vartate, kim acharaha. This should clearly be two separate words, kim acharaha. It is not, there is a compound here. So it's one whose achara is of what kind. So kaha acharaha yasya saha. Because kim can be dvitiya prathama ekvachanam of prajapadikam kim sarvanama shabdha. It's also an avyayam, by the way. So kim is also an avyayam. So it's even more confusing now. So kim can be an avyayam. It can be prathama or dvitiya ekvachanam napumsakalinge. It can also be samastam padam over here. So it is sarvanama shabda in a compound here. The famous tattvamasi, right? Tattvamasi. Tattvamasi. It mostly done tat tvam asi. Also make tattvam. Tasyatvam asi. You know, of course, these are kind of a bit shaky, but bottom line is that whenever you have a situation is where a declined form, undeclined form is the same, then you have this, like say Devi Shariram. Now this Devi could be outside the compound, because Devi can be prathama ekvachanam, can be inside the compound also. So this is also something. In fact, when you chant things like the Lalita Sahasranama Stotram, there will be many places like that. There will be many places because of the fact that a word like Sita, Lata, Rama, they give the same form. And also a word like Nadi give the same form in the prathama ekvachanam and the pratipadikam. In a compound, how do you decide a compound? Because of the supo dhatu prajapadika yoho, inside a compound sup doesn't stay. Inside a compound, there's no declension. That's how you know you're in a compound. Like for example here, simhikakhya nicharim. So here, the simhikakhya, there's no declension after that. So this has to be in the compound. So this has to be in a compound. Unless it's like a vocative case, he simhikakhya, in masculine. But same thing, word like Rama. Like, you know, say Rama Bharya. It could be He Rama. Could be He Rama also. Anyway, so that Tad, Ravi is correct, Tad Udaram is a Shashitat Purushaha from the context only. From the context only. But keep all options open until you can decide what to do. Okay. So let's see, Balaram, you can try the translation. Balaram, you try. Let's try. Further, he is met. But another ogress, Simhika by name. I think further is what?
Tathaiva.
In the same manner.
Okay.
Similarly.
Then, is it?
Yeah, then the another ogress. What's the word for ogress?
Nicharim. Nicharim, yeah.
Nicharim. Is this Paribadivam called Nish? Paribadivam called Nish and Nisha. Both mean night.
Both means?
Night, Ratri.
Oh,
So Nisha and Nish. Nish is ending in Palavi Shakara. So that will become Mudune Shakara by 8 to 36. Rashti Dishaha. And then you get the Janam Yashwante, Nit. So Nit is also a Prathama Ekvachanam Paribadivam Nish, Ratri. Ratri, also Nisha. You could have Nishachari, Nichari. You can have also both these forms. So that means one who roams around at night. Now here is a famous sutram which says Charat, Pratyesh Charat. We give the sutram quickly. I won't go in details, but we can, let me give this if you want to look in details. This is a Upada Samasaha. Nisham, so Nishicharati. Nishi, charati ti nicharati, one who roams at night. One who roams at night. And the beginning of, so, Samasa, there is this dhatu char, special sutram dhatu char. It should come here, chareshtaha, adhikarane chareshtaha. When somebody roams around in a certain place or a certain time, that gets the dhatu char pratyataha. So nishayam charati nishacharaha. Nishi charati nishachari. Now Ravi, question for you, Ravi, is why became nishachari? And not by the in the pratyata, anubandha lope a. The takara is an it by chutu. So only a remains. look at the vigraha vakyam, will be nishi charatiti nicharaha. Or if you take the alaukika vigraha, become nish plus ni, saptami ekvachanam. Tashchar plus ta. So I just put in a document the sutram nichari. So Ravi, question for you, Ravi, is that why nichari? Why not ajadyatashtapho? Because normally when you have a akaranta pradivadikam, you add the pratyaya tap, make it akasamadhyaya, like patita becomes patita, dushta becomes dushta. So why not nishachara, Ravi? Why nishachari? Any idea?
No idea, Sudeshi.
Okay, lesson for today. Lesson for today. That takas and it, that tit, that was an it. There is a very famous sutram called
Siddhani.
Yes, very good. Siddhani dvaya sajdadnai matrashtaya thakthai kai kvarapaha. The first part is if you have a t as an it, it takes a neep, it becomes chari. So any pratyaya which brings the t as an it with it, that tells you that in the feminine, it's going to become the long e. And not is 4115. It's an important sutram, Ravi. So any tit, and besides all these pratyas, the an, you know, the dvaya sajja dadnyan matracham tayap chak thai, all of these, they'll pick. Anyway, right now for us, this is the t as an it. So 4115, we need that to make nishachari, and also the 3216. 3216. We put in the document and we'll move on with that. So nichari. Nichari, nichari, nichari. Okay, nichari. Okay, so nichari is 3216, nichari. Nichari. Okay, 3216 and 415. Okay, Siddhani. Okay, let's continue. Let's see what the next part is. That okay. Now, Simhika by name.
Simhika.
Yeah. Akhya. So Akhya is a name. Akhya. So Simhika, Akhya, Yasyaha Sa. Simhika Akhya. Question for you, Ravi, is that now why not become Simhika Akhya? She's feminine, right? What about Simhika Akhya now? What is the thing, Ravi? Can you help us with that? Vigravakyam is Simhika Akhya. Is a feminine noun, Akhya. Yasyaha sa, one whose name is Simhika. It's a very useful usage. This is a very useful usage. This is very useful usage. Like, you know, Akhya, Akhya. Ravana Akhya Rakshasaha. Ravana by name. Dasharatha Akhya Raja. By name. So anything you can use the word Akhya to make a Bahuvrihi compound. With that which has that name. Named so and so. Named so and so. It doesn't have to be a person. It can be anything also. Ramayana Akhya Grantha. It's a book, it's a text named Ramayana. Ramayana Akhya Grantha. By name. It's a very useful Bahuvrihi compound. This is how we learn the language, you know. So you can make this compound word which is not common in English. This Bahuvrihi compound, other compound. Compounds are there in English, not so common. But Sanskritam, they give you such power. They use these usages. For that, you have to read Sanskritam, not only read English. You cannot get a usage. So, Ravi, any chance?
I don't know, Satish.
Okay. So, we can go through it now. So, first thing is that we want to make the raswa at the end. Raswa at the end. Okay. Now, well, let's see. How can I keep this one short for you? Okay. Let me, the sutram is that aneka manya padarthe is a bahuvari compound. You can have, you can compound variety of terms as long as they stand for something outside the compound. So here we have Simhika Akhya. Simhika is a name. We are talking about the demoness who has that name. We are not talking about the name itself. You have to make in a Bahuvrihi compound, you have to make sure that the thing or person what is being referred to is not in the compound. Pitambaraha, pitaha, pitam ambaram yasyasaha, mahabahuho, mahantau bahu yasyasaha, chitaprajnyaha, chitaprajnya yasyasaha. So he should not be in the compound. So Simhika is the name, so she is the one who has that name. Anyapadarthe is what this anyapadarthe. So Ravi, what happened to Ravi is that, do you know what is upasarjanam in a compound, Ravi? Upasarjanam?
Upasarjanam purvam.
Correct, that's the vini sutram. Give me the sanya okay. Sutram for that. Give me the sanya sutram for that. Prathamanudishtam.
Prathamanudishtam upasarjanam.
Samasi upasarjanam. Samasu upasarjanam. Prathamanudishtam. Samasu upasarjanam. So it is this one over here. In a compound, in the samasi vidhayaka sutram, that which division prathama gets the upasarjana sanya. We say, for example, in a kramadharya compound, visheshanam visheshena bahulam. That visheshanam is prathama nidishtam in the samasa vidhayaka sutram, in the sutram which authorizes the compound. That term which is in prathama, that indicates the upasarjanam. So visheshanam. Visheshanam, visheshena bahulam. So you can take an adjective and compound it to create a karmadharya compound. That visheshanam in the sutram is prathama. So the adjective gets the upasarjana sanya. In a bahuvari compound, we just learned about anekam anyapadarthe, anekam. That anekam prathama nidishtam is anekam. In a bahuvari compound, every term, the general rule, has the upasarjana sanya. So Ravi, in a bahuvari compound, every term, because of anekam prathama nidishtam, upasarjana sanya it has. And then we can use this sutram, Ravi, which is called gostriyoho upasarjanasya. Gostriyoho upasarjanasya. The ending becomes rasva. In the bahuvari compound, the ending vowel will become short. It becomes short all the time. So if there's a compound ending in the word go, or sripatyaha, yes, sriyami sripatyaha, feminine form at the end. In that case, what happens is that becomes the upasarjan, it has to be upasarjanam, but it becomes rasvaha, because simhika akhya. So now, but the question is that, in fact, this is very interesting, I don't want to spend too much time, but you know, Ravi is so interesting form that we have, Ravi. This is very interesting. See, the dhatu is kya.
Dhatu, yeah, it's kya prakathane.
So kya, very good. Very good. Thank you, Ravi. Now, if you really want, it goes in like full circles. So you take the dhatu kya and you form the feminine noun akhya, meaning name. How do that, Ravi? How do you do that? In this triyam jinadhikaraha. Right? And it says, atashopasargeho. Upasarga, the dhatu ending in akaraha. Nipatya ang comes over here. Ang. So this is a very interesting thing, because you're going to get, so let's, if you add the pratya ang, so for a three, let's form the word akhya first. Akhya is feminine noun akhya. Feminine noun akhya. So by 3-3-1-0-6, atashya upasarga, we can take a, plus the pratya, dhatu kya plus the ang pratyaha atoshapa sarge ang. Now this is 33106. What's the next chapter, Ravi? Ato lopeti cha. Ato lopeti cha. Ardha dhatu ke. So pratya ang sanya ardha dhatu kam. We have angam ending in the akaraha, ato lopa iticha, 6-4-1-6-4-6-4-6-4-6-4-6-4. I'm sorry to go into more detail, but it's a very fascinating process. You will see what happens now. First 6-4-6-4, ato lopa iticha. So let's follow this sequence now. You start with dhatu kya, ending in long a, dhatu pasha iticha, kya. So now Ravi, after being atolopo teacher, says if you have pratyaya which has sanya of adhadhatukam, it's ajadi, kitnit pratyaya, or has ida agamaha, otherwise we have nit pratyaya right now. This akaranta sangasya lopa bhavati, takes lopaha. So then after that, now we get the form, we get the form a, we get here. So a here plus ang anubandha lope a sanjam atha lopitya. So we lost the akara, which we came back to an akara. Then we add the ajajata stop to make it feminine, because it's a feminine word, and make akasamadirgha. So we will have to then make it akhya, the stop, and then of course use akasam, so 414, and then do the akasamadirgha to make it akhya. Akhya. 6111. Of course, anuchutu anumanalope a. So we had khya to begin with. We lost the akara. Then we added tap on top of that. We got the ak. So here itself we have gone through one process. Now we have akhya. Now the next step we are making the compound, saying simhika akhya yasya ha sa. So here we are making the bahuvari compound now, making it simhika akhya yasya ha. Sa, akhyasya ha, sa. Make it simhika khya. But then, as we just talked about, because upasana sanya in the bahuvari compound, the ending becomes short again. And it becomes short. So now what we get, we get now simhika khya. Akhya, because of that sutram, gostriyoho upasajanasya. We lost the akara again, we lost it. We again lost it, the second time. The second time, by the way. Second time it is gone. Because in the bahuvari compound, the ending becomes rasvaha. Rasvaha. Of the, if it is sripatya at the end, because the pratya tap we had, by the way, has to be sripatya at the end. You don't forget, that's why I went through this whole process. To form akhya first, which has a pratya tap in it. So in the akhya, this ending akara is not from the dhatu kya ravi, from the top pratyaya, from the top. Otherwise you could not use this one, because it says gosti upasajanasya striyoho. It has to be a stri pratyaya at the end, then only becomes short. So now we lost the akara second time, we got 1 to 48. But now this is qualifying that rakshasi. So again comes tap on top of it, I'm sorry for the pun. Tap comes on top of it. So we go back to Simhikakhya again. So now we get to Simhik. So this same by the same process, because this is a feminine, is qualifying somebody feminine. If Simhikakhya was qualifying somebody masculine, it would stay as it is. But Simhikakhya is now referring to a feminine entity. So we have to put tap on top of it again. Tap on top. And then make it Simhik by the same process. Make it Simhikakhya. So this again is will be 414. Akasamadirgha. So this is what happens now here. Look at what we have in the text, but what do we have in the text? We have Simhikakhya Nicharyam. Again it lost the akara again. So now how this is the third time now. What's happening, Ravi, over here? Last time, this is the last time. What happened over here now? What happened over here?
Is it again Gostriya or Upasarjanasya?
No, that we all, this is now the whole compound. Which was, we formed the bahuvari compound, make it simhikakhya. So, that's an adjective. Simhikakhya rakshasi. Nichari. Simhikakhya nichari. So she is one who roams at night, and her name is Simhika. So when, if you want to talk about the rakshasi or nichari, you have to say simhikakhya. But now what happened here now? You were happy with that. This bahuvari compound again becomes simhikakhya for the third time now. This is a sutram, Ravi, for you. Simhikakhya Nicharyam is that. What kind of compound is this, Ravi? Simhikakhya was bahuvriya.
This is Karmadharaya?
Very good. Karmadharaya compound. Very simple. Adjective noun. So it is, she is a rakshasi whose name is this. So this is qualifying the Nicharyam. So Ravi, sutram for you for today is that. In 6.3, section 6.3, I always talk about it all the time, is the Alugutara Pade. In a compound, when something happens to the prior member of a compound, That is the domain of 6.3. One more time. In a compound, Uttarapade Parataha. Uttarapadam has to be a compound only. Purapadasya Karyam. The Karyam of the Purapadam. Say Vishwamitraha. Yudhishthiraha. Atmane Padam. So all these, like Mahatma. Ekadasha. So all these kind of words, something is taking place in the Purapadam. Then that is the domain of 6.3. In that sutra is here, Ravi, which says that it should be here. Pumvat karma dharaya jatiya deshi yeshu. Karma dharaya compound, the prior member becomes pumvat, masculine like, becomes masculine like. So we have to undo the trap which we got now. In the become the bhav, so it becomes pumvatta. So, let's say dushta buddhi, simple compound. Dushta buddhi equal dushta buddhi. Not dushta buddhi, dushta buddhi. Right? So because pumvat bhavaha. Pumvat means like masculine. If you have a in a karmadharya compound, that pura padam becomes pumvatta. So even though the vigravakti means dushta buddhi, meaning in the compound becomes dushta buddhi. So here by 6342 now, final, this is the final step. By 6342, we will have to remove that top which we just did. And when we put in the compound, we'll have to finally make it into pumvat bhavaha, make it masculine like. So became simhi kakhya nitcharyaham. Nitcharyaham.
You missed me, Tarasadish.
Thank you.
Also in the Vigraha Vakya, right above this, Yasyaha, the Visarga is missing.
Thank you. Simikakya. So now this is, we use 6.3, Pumvad Bhava. Pumvad Bhava. Okay, let's finish one more time. So Dhatu was Kya. In the Dhatu part. Dhatu was Kya. Okay. From that we made a feminine noun called Akya. In that process we lost the Akara interim there. Because of the Atolopaiticha, then we brought, so the Dhatu's Akar is already lost way back there. So Dhatu's Akar is already lost in that step. It doesn't come back. It is gone. But we brought back an Akaraha, which was the Tap Pratyaha, which is a feminine noun. So it came back, but not Dhatu's Akara, but a Tap Pratyaha. Then when we made into this Bhavari compound, because of Ghostriyoho Pasujanas here, this ending Sripatyaha became Rasvaha, by the way. Not Pumvat Bhava, but Rasvaha. Two different things now. This 2448 does Rasvaha. So it became Rasvaha and became Simhikakhya. But now this is qualifying a feminine Rakshasi again. He brought back the top and make it Simhikakhya Rakshasi. But Simhikakhya went into a compound again, Karmadharya compound. And now again we got Pumvat Bhava. And then it was finally lost again. The top was lost. So it's a very, very interesting sequence. So Dhatu Akara was lost back here itself. Atvalopaiticha, it's already gone. So this was the end of Dhatu Akara. Top came. The top was also lost because of the Upasana Sanya Bahuvrihi, the ending, Sri Pratyaka at the ending becomes short. So, then, but you brought the top back again because it's a feminine term, qualifying somebody feminine. If this was qualifying of masculine thing, it would stop here. But it's quite feminine. But that went into Karmadharya compound in Simikakhyanichari. So again we lost that Sipatya because of Pumvat Bhava. So Mudbhava. Okay. I hope you enjoyed that sequence. You get it, Ravi? Okay, Ravi.
Yes, it is. Very interesting.
Interesting sequence, right? So okay. Now I'm sorry, not this one. Let me look at okay. So, Balaramji, I'm sorry for the interruption, but
no problem.
Standing with, so standing, what is a standing? What is a, like waiting.
Yapadeya?
Pratipalayanti.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Pratipaspal. Pal means to protect.
Pal, yeah, it was there last week, last for Pratipalayanti.
Yeah, last class also. We have Surasam Pratipalayanti.
Mm-hmm.
Pratipalayanti means waiting, standing, you know, anticipating. Pratipali and team. Now this, what kind of pratyaya is this, Ravi, from at the end, Pratipali and team?
Is it because of Ugitascha?
No, Shatru pratyaya, Shatru pratyaya.
Oh, Shatranda, yes, okay.
Shatru pratyaya, it's a present participle, it's a quite unique, Vartamanikudanta, Shatru pratyaya. Ugitascha only comes, when Ugitascha comes, it doesn't mean the num. Yes, very good, Ugitascha does come over here, you're right, Ugitascha. Pratipalayat, Pratipalayati. How about the nakara there, that we did in the last class, class before that, I think, two classes back? Pratipalayan nakara there, Ravi? So Pratipalayat, Shatrupatya.
Ugita cham sarvanamasthane.
Sarvanamasthane, but not this one now. Not this one. So what Ravi told us was that while he's thinking, is that we got Pratipalayat. Again, we won't go through derivation, take us too long again, but that I think Pratipalayat, it is the, you can see the aya. First of all, look at the form aya. Aya. Nich Pratyaya, the nich has taken guna, followed by shab become aya. Pratipalayat. Let's look at the, give Ravi some time to think. Let us look at this, dhatu pal. Palayamam, palayati. So, dhatu pal. So palayati, yeah, this is a, by the way, in the online after dictionary there's a typo. The zeros have gone away. In the tens have become ones, the twenties have become twos. So the in the online after dictionary, be careful. Even if it says 1p, it means 10p. Because the 10 has become 1. So we can look at the form palayet, piteva palayet putran, so palayet is to protect, to watch, to guard. The tenth gana dhatu, so palayet. So Ravi said,
atvasantasya cha dhatu.
No, that's for dirgha. That's for dirgha. You're talking about 6, 4, 18. That's for dirgha vidhanam, not for num magama.
Oh, okay, num.
The one you're talking about, this one. The atmasandhishta dhatu Ravi is in 6, 4.
Yeah, that means upadha dirgha.
But dirgha. We want num magama, Ravi.
Num
magama. You know, I told you those four exam questions, they come all the time. In the exam, they come all the time, Ravi. This is the Vyakaran exam. Okay, here it is. You remember that? Nabhyastha chatu, etc. We did two classes back, Ravi.
Nabhyastha chatu, yes.
Nabhyastha chatu, vanapumsakasya. Achi nadya ornum and shap shanor nityam. Shap shanor nityam. So what is happening is that if you have a sri pratyaha, shi nadyoho, following, and this is in the concept of the shatru pratyaha. Shatru is there, followed by sri pratyaha. Nadi, nadi. And then the ikara there. And the angam for the shatru is ending in a akaraha. Palaya, palaya shatru you had. So, and if that angam is ending in a shap or a shan, nityam numagama, nityam num. Let's say gachat, simple form. So, nari gachat, gachanti nari. A woman who is going. So, one more time. At shinadyor num. If you have a avarnanta mangam, and the shatru is in between, and followed by either the she, napumsakalingeya, tatama dvitiya divachanam, or the sri pratyaha, long e, then you get the numa agamaha optionally, but shap shano nityam, 781. Okay, anyway, let's go. So this was two classes back. You can go and revise this. Two classes back, we had this in detail. So these are very confusing rules, these four. Nabhyastha chatuho, vanapumsakasya, achinadjornam, shap shano nityam. So right now we have pratyaya shap. Shab, because the niche came in there, shab. So 781, and Ravi also told us that Ugitascha, because we had the Parvatikam palayat, so that we make it palayati first, by adding Ugitascha. If you have an Ugit, then the Pratya Nip comes, so palayati, so 416, and then 7181. So palayantim means waiting. Dvitiya ek vasanam, finally, dvitiya ek vasanam, so pala yanti alayanti. So 416 ugitascha shatrupatyaha 7181. So palayan team, let's continue with that. So next thing we have is, so standing with her mouth wide open. What do you think, Balanji?
Mukham vyadaya.
Mukham vyadaya. Mukham vyadaya. Again, you know what vyadaya is for pratyaya? Lyap is there. Should be in the pratyaya ktva. You have many examples came to you. I hope this is that. Saman pratyaya purva kale. When one person does two actions, the prior action takes a pratyaya ktva. When ktva goes in a compound, becomes lyap. What is the dhatu here, Balanji? It's vi ada.
Ad, maybe something.
No,
something
da,
just,
da.
Da, okay.
Da, da. Da is to give. Ada is to take. And viada is to kind of expand.
Mm-hmm. You know, yeah, I figured out that the V is a prescript.
Yeah, it's upasarga. Yeah. Then ah upasarga also is there. Ah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Ada. Come, you chant purusuktam and you chant purusuktam?
Yeah.
Ashvino, Vyattam, 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 your expanded mouths, Ashvino, Vyattam. So, so V, same dhatu, V, Adah, Vyattam.
I think you said the same thing even last class also, I forgot.
So, V, Adah. So, V, Adah means, there's Patya Lab. So, Mutham Mukham Vyadaya, having expanded her mouth, she was way. So, she is a Samana Kartri. And she in two actions, she expands her mouth in gasitum vyadaya. In order to
devour or to gulp.
To gulp.
Yeah.
Now, Ravi, Tumun Pratya, we talked in the earlier class today. What sutram, Ravi? We just talked about it in just a few minutes ago.
Tumun valau kriyarthayam kriyayam.
Very good. Kriyartham. Because there's no dhatu ish over here. There's nothing else. So kriyarthayam kriyayam. So when you have a kriya, she's being done for the sake of another kriya. This is a vyadaya. She's expanding her mouth for the purpose of swallowing him. So this action of expanding the mouth is the kriyartha kriya. It is an action whose artha, prayojanam, is anya kriya. It's being done in order to do this kriya. So when such a kriyartha kriya is close by, in connection, then this other dhatu here takes the, for the sake of which this other kriya was being done, so this dhatu gras will take the pratyatuman avyam. Gasitum vyadaya. Okay, her mouth wide to gulp Hanuman. Hanuman understood. He enters, what do you think?
Pravishya.
Pravish, having entered. Same thing, Pravishya. Again, Saman Karta Hanuman, having entered. Uttara Kriya is going Vyapadayat. Ravi will do it for us. Vyapadayat. Lang Lakaraha. That is the verb. Ekating Vakyam, by the way. Everything. This ends the Vakyam. Simple Vakyam is Hanuman. Tasyaha Udaram, Tadudaram. Tadudaram. Vyapadayat. So Hanuman basically destroyed her stomach. Vyapadayat. Okay, let's finish the sentence. We could Ravi for this form. But enters, having entered, Pravishya.
Pravishya.
Her mouth is what?
Understood, I guess. Yeah. Mukham.
Yeah, understand. You're right. Pravishya. You're right. Correct. Understood. After assuming a minute form.
A minute form is Sukshma Deham.
Deha.
Svikrita is assuming?
Svikrita is to accept. Uh-huh. Except, in fact, we talked about in the class today. What is Sutram Ravi today for the class? Svikrita. Svikrita, what's Sutram Ravi?
I don't remember, Satish.
We just talked a few minutes ago. This is this one. Abhutadad bhave kru bhuvasti yoge sampadikate chvi. Patya chvi. We come in the sense of that which was not that you make into that. Svikritya. That which was not his, he made his. Means he accepted it. Having accepted, svikaraha is to accept. Accept means that which is not yours, you make yours. So means you accept something. And then asya chvau, that the chvi is a zero. which comes on the condition that has to be used with dhatu kru, bhu, or as. Remember that. The pratyaya chvi only comes on the condition that kru, bhu, asti yoge. Panini says, kru, vasti yoge. Kru, bhu, asti yoge. So it has to be used with dhatu kru, bhu, or as. Only then chvi can be used. If you take a pratyabhidhikam, add pratyaya chvi, which is a zero to it. Now that can be used in connection with the dhatu kru, bhu, or as in the sense of which was not that is made that. Oh. Spashtikaranam, as we taught in the class today, shuklikaranam, something which is not white you make white, shuklikaranam. Spashtikaranam, which was not clear you make it clear. Oh. So, 1, 5, 4, 15, how became svi kuta, with the ikaraha kuta agataha, asyachvau, is when the chvi pratyaya follows. Then if you have a avarnantam angam, it takes the ikara adeshaha alone just. So svikrita. Svikrita, we put these two documents. So we just interesting. We can see now as we learn more and more, we can spot more and more rules, right? It becomes a little bit easier for us. So as we go year by year, we'll be able to spot more and more these forms and not be fumbled by them. So you know. Svikrita. Kubhasti yoga. So and then asyacho, svikrita, accepted. So what is the Vigravakyam, Ravi, finally? What do you think we'll try Vigravakyam for me? Vigravakyam for this one. Svikrita sukshma gehaha. What is Vigravakyam? Sukshma deha karmadhara, right? Sukshma shasau adaha. See, deha, I think, is also pullinge, napumsakalinge, deha, deham. So this is the Bahuvri compound, but so first make karmadharya, sukshma deha. See, we all talked about svikrita. Talked about svikrita. What kind of kama samas svikrita you think, Ravi? What kind of samas is svikrita?
Svikrita.
We talked about that. It gets the gati sanya, Ravi. We talked about that. That the chvi pratyaha, chvi antam gets the gati sanya. By urya adi chvi da chascha. Right? It's a gati samas. Svikrita gati samasa. So gati samasa is a special kind of tatpurusha samasa. Svikrita is kugati pradayaha. So by 2 to 18, kugati pradaya is a gati samasa. So because that chvi antam, it got the gati sanya, kugati pradaya 2 to 18, and then, you know, we had the by uryadi chvi rachascha. Uryadi chvi rachascha. We got the 1, 4, 6, 2. I can add them here now. So that is the gati samasa there. Finally, what kind of samasa is it? From 61.
So it's
Bahuvrihi. Oh. Yeah, correct. Bahuvrihi, correct. 1, 4, 61. Oh. So svikrataha sukshma dehaha yena saha. So one who has accepted a miniature form. Svikrataha. Sukshma dehaha yena saha. Okay, so after assuming that is svikrita, minute is sukshma form, deha, and comes out. Well, not, I think not there, right?
I don't think so.
I think you take from the prayas, take from the anuvritti. Bahi niragachat, there's no other choice now. So bahi is out, niragachat. I think, you know, this you have to really, this is not there, it's not there.
Yeah, but that out is for surasa.
I'm sorry?
That out is for surasa, right?
Surasa, but he came out here also, but he came out after killing her. So here, so what we have to do is take this verbal form, vyapadayata. What is dhatu here? V, A plus pad in the causative. And it could become padi. Vyapad. Again, you can see the form aya in here. Aya, aya. Vyapadayata. Aya, aya.
Mm-hmm.
That's like palayati. Again, the aya.
Aya.
That means the nit has taken guna. Become E, became A. Then the following shap, echo yava yavaha, becomes aya. So the aya is not a pratyaya, but the aya is a sign. You can look for the aya. And you can then, if you see a form like that, then probably a good guess is that it's body going to be nishpatya in their home. In Gita, buddhim mohaya siyomeyaho. Tadekam vada nishchitya. Diyana shriyoham apnuya. Mohaya siyomeyaho. Mohaya si aya aya. So you are causing, you're messing up my mind. Mohaya, you're as if deluding my mind. Mohaya si. So causing to be deluded. So okay, Ravi, let's finish off this one. Vyapa, it's kind of straightforward. Vyapa dayata. So first made the dhatu padi, right, Ravi?
Yes.
What sutra for that?
Sanadyanta dhatavaha.
But how to bring the niche vidhayaka sutra?
Niche hetumati cha.
Very good. Hetumati cha. Niche come by two rules. One is the swarthi niche, churadibhyas, and then is the hetumati cha. Hetu means, where is hetu defined, Ravi Nashadhe?
I don't know, sir.
Satrajako hetu shcha. So karta is what, right? Satantra karta, right? Satantra karta. Then tatrayojako hetuscha. In the adhyas of the karakeya. So prayojakaha is one who instigates or propels, causes another doer. Is the here right here. Satantra karta. Tatrayojako hetuscha. So kartu prayojakaha. One who employs him to do something. It's called hetu. So hetu is a technical term here. And when the hetu is used, means the one who's causing or instigating, and he's connecting with the verb. So who's the one here? It is the Hanuman. Dhatu pad. Again, what happens is dhatu is because upasarga vashat. Let's take a different meaning. So what we have is we have this vyapadayata. See, dhatu pad is to go. This dhatu pad is a very notorious dhatu. Used with only upasarga most of the time. Upapadyate, sampadyate, vipadyate, apadyate, patipadyate, prapadyate. Very, very variety of meaning. Sampatti, apatti, vipatti, you know, pratipatti, you know, comes in Gita so many places. Prapanna, it comes in Gita. So unfortunately, it's very hard. Now, vipad is the, and with the causative on top of that now. So you know, you can imagine that. So really, if pad is to go, so padi means to make to go, right? But it will not give the full meaning here. So we means can mean, ah means like, it's very hard to make like a mathematic calculation here. You have to know the idiomatic combination. So we are pad nich. Aptek is taking to destroy something, right? We check that. Let's look at the, so vyapad. Take vyapad in the causative. So vyapad. Vyapad. And if you look at the to die, to perish, to fall down. This is to fall down, which is okay, means to go, to fall down, not bad. But like, okay, we can deal with it. So vyapad is to fall down. And we are, so in the causative, is to make to fall down, means to destroy. Destroy, to hurt. So anyway, so vyapad is to. In fact, it's not the apatti, right? Apatti is like a difficulty. So that's a good meaning to start from, maybe. Then vyapatti also is to kind of be in a bad situation. So then we causative. So to put somebody in a bad situation, you should destroy. So this is how we have to understand. You have to use upasargas from the prayoga, that word that you know. You cannot use vyakaranam for this. Vyakaranam will not tell you the meaning of vyapade. Vyakaranam is no use. You can derive the form, but you know, artha, so it's because, see, Pani doesn't give meanings. He already assumes you know the prayogaha and the prayogartha. Vyakaranam is only to derive the forms, not to get the meaning of these words.
Satish,
so anyway, yes.
There is a famous shloka kind of thing for this upasarga.
I know. This is upahara, samuhara, vihara, like that.
Upasargena dhatvartho balad anyatra niyate. Ahara, ahara, vihara, samhara, pariharavat.
Pariharavat. So what Ravi said is that by the upasarga, the dhatu artha balena, niyate anyatra niyate, anyatra niyate, means taken elsewhere. The meaning of a dhatu is forcefully taken elsewhere. Like he said, vihara, ahara, samhara, dhatu is to take away. Vihara, viru is to sport. Samhru is to wind up or destroy. Right? So pariharaha is to kind of to avoid. Lot of meanings. Ahara is to intake, to eat something, ahara. So that is, so this same thing is dhatupa also like that, Ravi, same thing. Apatti, sampatti, vipatti, patipatti, upapatti, upapatti, how about that? It comes in Gita. Itattu upapadyate. So you know upapadyate. It's not appropriate for you. Upapadyate. Upapad means to be appropriate also. It's a different meaning. Anyway, so this is lang lakaraha, nothing much, nothing, once you know that, nothing really very complicated. So we just put a couple of things here and move ahead. So we get the dhatu, padi. What's the here, Ravi?
Sanadhyanta dhatva.
No, before that, to do the angakaryam.
Atta upadhaya.
Very good. Atta upadhaya. Atta upadhaya vriddhi. Vriddhi atta upadhaya. When the pratyaya falling in nit, chavarga panchama, chavarga panchama is nit, then the upadha akara takes vriddhi atta upadhaya. Anuruchya acho niti comes from there. And then we take padi, and then what Ravi is saying is that by 3132, it's a derived dhatu. It's a dhatu sanya. We need that. Without that, we cannot do anything with it. You get a new, because dhatu sanya is coming for the vayu dhatuva, vayaya. But this also, we need the dhatu sanya. We cannot do anything unless we give dhatu sanya. So, dhatu sanya. And then we add the pratyaya lung, and we, you know, I skip some steps now. So, padi plus lung, bring the adagamaha, lung. That's the last step, actually. And then we'll do the shap in the meanwhile. Then shap will do guna for padi, becomes pade. The ending ikar of tip will go by itascha. I'm going too fast, but we've done this shoot in the class before. It'll take a long time to go. If you want, I'll put the numbers here for you. Becomes a pada yat. So we just told the lung was used. Anadhyatani lung, right? Right, Ravi?
Anadhyatani lung.
Correct. What number is that, Ravi?
3-4 something.
No, 3-2 something. Oh.
3-2.
Bhute, Bhute, from 3284 is started. So 3211, 3211, 32111, that anadhyatane lung, lung, sorry. One, and then we did the 3478, not putting all the steps. Itascha, the ending ikara was gone from Katari Shap. Then Sarvadhatuka, Anadhatuka Yoho, Gunaha. Echoyava, Yavaha, and these are basic steps, okay? And then, of course, the Adagamaha, Lung Lung Lung, Shurzataha, 6471. And then to that you add Vya. So it's Vya Upadayata. See, unfortunately, what's happening here, Balaraman, is that the Adagamaha has been eaten up over here. So we have to be a little bit careful. Because you see, it's really Upadayata. But because of the Akara coming here, Akasvami Dirgaha, you cannot see the Adagama anymore. So you have to now rely on this ending over here, this itascha ending. Will give you the hint, lang lakaraha. Normally the adagama is very reliable to give you the hint of the lang lakara or lung lakaraha. But in this case, because you upasarga and doing the akasama dirgha, you have lost the adagama in between here. It's not lost, taken the ekadesha. So vyapadayata means that he caused to fall, caused to perish, means destroy, basically destroyed. Splitting. I think splitting. Oh. What's her belly?
Chaduram.
Chaduram. Chaduram. Tasya udaram chaduram. And I think splitting.
It's coming twice is again. Vidaram purvakam.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Where it came twice, you're saying?
Udaram, because
the belly came twice.
Oh no, sorry.
Udaram pravishya. See, that's why the translation is not faithful to that. You see, they said, I took the translation from another book, and that's what happens. He serves me right. Because I took the translation from another book. I thought you meant meaning the same text, but I guess it's slightly different. You're right, because it should be having entered her. Now, wait a minute now.
It says he enters her mouth, but it should have been.
Wait a minute now. The thing is that, is he entering her stomach, or is he destroying her stomach? What do you think, Ravi? This udaram is the object of pravishya, or vyapadet, or both? Having entered her mouth.
My guess will be he should have entered his mouth. He cannot enter the stomach.
Enter the mouth. So then you can make it udaram vyapadayata. Right? or entered the stomach through the mouth. He entered it, destroyed and came out. Four things of which one it is. By the placement, by the way, it should be Udaram Pravishya. Because very, it next is prior to Pravishya. On the placement of the word, it should go with Pravishya. On the meaning and the context, though, you want to take it with the Vyapadayata. My guess is as follows. My guess is that having entered her stomach, into bracket through the mouth, he destroyed it after tearing it apart. Vidarana Purvakam. This is an adverb for Vyapadayata. Vidaranam Purvam Yasyatat. Dhatu Dhru. Dhru Dharanam. Dhru, V Dhru is to split open, to tear. Vidru. This is, and Dhatu, so Vidaranam. So I think this one we think also, is there a niche in here, Ravi, what do you think? A niche in here, Vidru? Dhru. Vidaranam.
That's a vruddhi.
Sorry? Is to split, again, yeah, tenth gana, yeah, that's it. Vidarayati, to split, to tear. So make a dhatu vidari. Vidru plus nich achoniti. Make it vidari, vidari, and then see to render, to tear in pieces. So here also we have a nich, because it will not become dar otherwise. It will not become dar. If you don't get niche, how will it become dar? It will not become dar. So let's take the vi plus dru plus niche. Again, hetumati. Hetumati cha. 3126. Might be swarthi also, which is gana. It might be swarthi also. So 25 or 26, depending on what gana it is in, might be swarthi. And then make it vi dari, because vi is the upasarga, doesn't participate in this operation. Vidari, achoniti, followed by uran raparaha, vidari, vidaranam, add pratyaya lyutcha, to make it into a neuter noun. Vidaranam means splitting open, lyutcha, vidaranam. Final step, Ravi, lyu becomes anah, and after that?
Yuvaranako.
And after that?
Dharanam.
We got V, Dari, Ana. Now.
So then Natvam.
No, before that. Nishlopa.
Oh, Niraniti.
Niraniti, very good. Niraniti, very good, very good. So now become Vidaranam. Just put all the final steps here. V, Dharanam. Vidara, Vidarana. Vidaranam, we should put it. Vidaranam. So here what we did was we used Pratyaya Lyutcha. Lyut, you became ana, you were anakav, and niraniti ho. Nitchik lopaha, as Ravi said, 842 natvam, vidaranam. Vidarana purvakam means preceded by vidaranam, means along with splitting it open. So he destroyed it in a manner such that, this is an adverb to vyapadayata. He destroyed in a manner like, let's say they split it. So how you can take it like splitting open, he destroyed it. So he says splitting her belly, Vidarana Purvakam, and killing her, Vyapadayata.
I think that's where does Purvakam come here? What is the meaning?
Purvakam is a Bahuvari compound. Gita example, anybody guys? Gita example, Purvakam. Very famous in Gita. Yajanti Vidhi Purvakam. Avidhi Purvakam means preceded by, means it's idiomatic usage, means accompanied by. It's an adverb. So it is done, an action is done accompanied by something. So it's a Bahuvari compound. So Vidhi, Vijanta Vidhi Purvakam. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm not in the Gita. okay, Vidhi Purvakam. Vijanta Vidhi Purvakam. Vidhi Purvakam. Here it is, 617. So Atma-sambhavita astabdhat, it comes in two, three places in Gita. Dhanamana-madhan-vitaha, yajante nama-yajniste, dambhena-vidhi-purvakam. So they perform sacrifices, and they are very intoxicated with their wealth and their honor, with only in name. Nama-yajni-yajante, dambhena, out of haughtiness, avidhi purvakam, in such a manner is not precedent, it is not accompanied by the vidhi. So not in keeping with the vidhi, they perform sacrifice, avidhi purvakam. So this is a bhavari compound. Priti purvakam, yes, thank you Radha. Priti purvakam in Gita also, priti purvakam. So priti purvakam, bhajatam priti purvakam. So they worship me with love, accompanied by love. How? Preceded by love means accompanied by love. So affection. So it will be a bhavari compound. In our case, what we will do is that we say vidharanam purvam yasya tat. It is an action which is preceded by splitting. Pratyakha kap pratyaha. In the end of the bahuvris, these bahuvris can take the kap pratyaha optionally. It can kap pratyaha. This is the last part of 5.4. Pratyaha parascha. Pratyaha kap comes in here. And sheshad vibhasha. So when you look at the pratyaha kap, the ka coming in there, you also look at suspect the bahuvri. Vidharana purva kam. So it's an adverb. The bahuvri compound is now declined. Napumsaka linge dvitiya ekavachanam kriya visheshanam tu vyapadayata. So that's he, and killing her vyapadayata. After this is splitting, that's because preceded by splitting her belly, udaram. So udaram, I think, so udaram Lusa is going with both, I think. Having entered her stomach, he destroyed it, having split it open. Vidharana purva kam. Okay. Now the next thing is athacha. You want to try? Let me try this next one.
Sure.
Then what is then?
Atha. Maybe I'll just can I just read it?
Sure. I have to. Okay. I'm sorry. I have to do it like this now. So then contracting his body into a minute form again, in order to preclude the fear of the ogress. He descends on the, let me do something temporary, let me just take this down here, make it easy for you, one second. Let me just copy this down here. Okay, let's see now. Atharcha is what?
Then
contracting his body into a minute form again.
Deham is coming here, so that must be somewhere.
This one.
Anukritya, okay.
Contacting him. So nija deham tanukritya. Tanukritya. Contacting his form. Nija deham tanukritya. So Ravi Sutra, I just gave you Ravi. Tanukritya. Dirgha adesha. But tanu, the same form. Chvi pratyava. Chvi. The same thing. Tanu karoti. Tanu is slim, you know. Tanu is small. So that which was not small, he made small. In fact, interesting, we just led a cheap attend in the first class today, and we got Ravi, right? Two examples back to back over here. Back to back examples. Tanu Kritya Svi Kritya. So now again, Pratya Chvi. So Tanu plus Chvi. So Sutra, for making it Dirgha Ravi, I just gave it to, I think. What is the one?
Is it Asyat Swam?
No, that's only Asyat Chvi Ikaraha.
Oh, Ikaraha.
I want Dirgha Vidhanam. Shiva Ucha. Shiva Ucha. Shiva Ucha, Shiva Ucha. That is the 7.4.26. When the Chvi Pratyaya follows, Ajanta Mangam you have, right? It becomes Dirgha. So Tanu. Tanu is short U of Tanu Kritya. Tanu Kritya is this form, immediately sense. So you want to use same Pratyaya Chvi, but again the same kind of compound formation. Everything is the same as before. Only thing is that here we need to also make it into the Chvaucha. Mm-hmm. This sutra is not used a lot, so it's difficult to remember this one. I'm sorry, this is not working. Okay. Tanu Kritya. Okay, Tanu Kritya. Tanu Kritya. So 5, 4, 50, same old steps. 7.4.26. Remaining are the same steps as before here. You made the compound. Let me just do this one. Okay, so that's one thing. Tanu Kritya. Okay. Now, coming back to translation, what do we have here? contracting his body vigadare tanukritya nija deham into a minute form again. There's no again over here, right? There's no again, I think. Again is not here, I think. Again.
Acha is there.
Yeah. Atacha, maybe, yeah, possible. In order to preclude the fear of the Rakshasas.
Ishya is there, so Varayishyan.
Varayishyan. This is a future participle. Future participle. It means when just about to do that. Oh. So Gamishyan. Oh.
Is the Aya coming here too?
Yes, it's coming. But it's not Aya. Only I is coming. I, not Aya. Because we didn't get a Shab Pratyaya. We got a Pratyaya Sya.
Okay.
Ida Agamaha become Isya. That Aya comes when the Pratyaya Shab comes. That only comes in Lakaras, you know, the Lat, Lot, Lung, Vidiling. This is a Rut Lakaraha. Rut Pratyaya. So we'll come to that one. But Rakshasa Janasambraham.
Fear of the aggression.
So Sambrahma is like the alarm. Alarm,
fear.
Alarm. So this is the fear of the aggression. Rakshasa Sambrahmam. Varishan. So Varish means
to preclude.
To ward off, to ward off, to avoid. So about to, as he was about to avoid the, means, or ward away, the alarming the Rakshasas. So Varishan, Ravi, what is happening here? Pratya Shatru from here now, this Sutam here. You want to try? Varishan.
Is it a decline like Pachan?
Yeah, like Pachan, correct. Pachan. But I'm saying the Pratya Shatru, normally we are used to using the Vartamani Kudanta, right?
Hmm.
Normally we use the Lata Shatru Shana Char Pratama Samadhi Karane, right?
Yes.
That's what we normally use. Just in place of Lut. Just in place of Lut. This is not Lut. This is Rut. So what do we use now? Because that will give, this will give present participle. Lata Shatru Shana Char Pratama Samadhi Karane. Vartamani. Vartamani. Vartamani Kudanta. Vartamani Lut. This is Bhavishyati. So Bhavishyati, as Panini is very kind in Ashtadhyayi, because he goes in the Bhute, past tense, then Panini goes Vartamani, in the all order of time, chronological order, Vartamani, and then finally Ravi Panini goes Bhavishyati, in 333, Bhavishyati. In Bhavishyati, Ravi, there is a sutram called Nitasadva. Nitasadva. So the Lut can take, just like Lut can take Kshatri Shanach, so can Lut. Much less common, but is there. Lutasadva. Lutasadva. Now what is Sat? What is Sat, Sanya? That came back here. Is Tau Sat. Tau Sat. So the Kshatri and Shanach, Ravi, got this Sat Sanya. Tau Sat. And then by the Sutram Lutasadva, this can take a, the Lut can take the Kshatri Shanach, of course, as the case may be. So 3314, put some numbers only, we won't go all details. 3314 and Tau Sata is 32127. So Varishan, 3314, 32127. Varishan. Of course, Idagamaha, Nich and all that. So we skip those steps now, we're running out of time. So Varishan. Now this was the Litas, I mean Tau Sat and Litas Sadva. Sadva become Kshatri, and then you know Shya Pratyaya comes, then the Idagama comes, Guna comes, Echo Yava Yavaha becomes Vara Yishyat, and Vara Yishyan is Pratama Ek Vachanam Vara Yishyan. The sense of basically see, because the reason, the meaning comes about to so like vakshamana artha, vakshamana, about to be, which is, you know, which is about to be told now, about to be told, vakshamana, probably coming next, coming next. So pravish, anyway, so that's so the, I'm sorry, the reason why you got the what do I do now? I lost my strategy. Okay.
You can hit forward, Satish.
Basics. Tantrika Jnanam Nasti. Okay. The reason why I'm talking about this, about to do that, Ravi, is that because of the, see, the lut comes anadyatane. Lut is used anadyatane, not of today. Future, distant future, right? That's why the lut is sheshe, but sheshe, the anadyatana part is taken by lut, isn't it? So this means the near future. The near, that's why this participle, this lutas sadva, in the sense of something which is about to happen, about to do. Because anadyatane is not of today, distant future, taken by lut. So lut is sheshe. So it's become varishan, means about to ward off, as he was about to ward off the fear of the rakshasas, varishan. And then he descends. What's the word for descend? Descends from
Niyapatat.
Again, the ending ikara, look at the, first of all, spot the adagamaha. Between ni and apatat, and patat, adagama is there. It's because the ni is upasarga. It's a prutak padam. Separate is separate padam. So that will not intervene with the adagamaha. So ni apatat, dhatu pat, vadigana straightforward form. Again, itascha sutram, ending ikaraha, niyapatat, is patam purushata ekavachanam. So he descends, so and then?
Mountain peak is Giri Shikare.
Giri Shikare, very
Shikare.
Good. Shikare.
Lanka is Lanka.
Outside?
Bahihi?
Sita Bahistha.
Oh, Bahistha.
Lanka Bahistha, which is situated outside Lanka, is qualifying Giri. Lanka Bahistha Giri Shikare. So it is the mount, it is on the top of a mountain which is situated outside Lanka. Lanka Bahistha Giri Shikare. So Varishan, in fact, Ravi, I got one more thing for you. He says, in order to, I'm sorry, but this thing is coming in my mind, in order to, right? In order to. Now, that means that in the with the hetu. Give me the example Ravi when gave Shatrupatyaha. Like Dhanam Arjayan Tishtati. So he stays in order to earn money, Vasati. This is Sutram called Lakshana Hetu. So this Shatru Shanach can also be used in the sense of for the purpose of. Maybe you can use that here, maybe it's possible. Because it says, see, lakshana hetvoha kriyayaha. This 3:2:126, we can maybe try that. Because this is varishyan, means in order to. Not about to, but means order to. So 3:2:126, if we try that, we can try that. 3:2:126 might work here. 3:2:126 is the lakshana heto arthe vartamana dhatu manishtis for lut. No, I'm sorry, only for lut. Okay, I thought we could use this one. Look at the example much fit here. Ajayan vasati. So he stays, for earning money he stays there, for the sake of. He does not, meaning is not earning money he stays. He stays, he lives in a particular place for earning money. So what we have here is that in order to preclude, so varishan. But the problem is that this is only lataha. Lataha. So maybe it may not work too well. Anyway, it looks like it's a hetu arthe. Okay, do we get everything now? Then it's athacha. Rakshasa jana sambramam is the fear of the ogre, the alarming the rakshasa jana.
Fear of the ogres, yeah.
Varishan, as I said to you, in order to
maybe order to
hetu artha. Nijadeham, his own form.
Minute form.
Tanukritya.
Contracting.
Taking minute form. No, that's the minute form. Tanukritya is minute form.
Oh, okay.
His body is this Nijadeham. Minute form.
Contracting is?
Contracting into the minute form. This thing is Tanukritya. Contracting into a minute form, Tanukritya.
Okay.
Lanka Bahistha Girishikare.
Outside Lanka.
And the Shikara is peak, Giri is mountain.
Mountain. Yeah, but that's
outside Bahistha. So Ravi, one more sutta for you, Ravi. Bahistha Estheho. Deshastha. Kayastha. What the word is from? Istha. Stha. What sutta? Very, very famous sutta, Mr. Ravi. Do you know that one?
No, Satish.
It's called Supistaha. Supistaha. 324. Supistaha. Supistaha is, this can be used. Supistaha says that Subanti Uttara Upapade, Tishti is a very famous sutta. Tishthatehe, Krapratya Bhavati, Samastaha, Vishamastaha, Sustaha, Swastaha. So one who is situated in an even place, means he is comfortable, he is stable. Vishamastaha, he is unstable. Vishamastaha. Giristaha, he is on the mountain. Very nice. Vanastaha, he is in the thing. So it can be like Sustaha, well situated. Dustaha, badly situated. Swastaha, cure himself. Dhatustha, in the pratyaya, ka. I can miss sutam here for Ravi to remove the akaraha. So sama plus ni plus tha plus ka. Akar lopa by?
This atalopaticha.
Very good. Atalopaticha. Samastaha, Vishamastaha, Supistaha. So very, comes in Gita, Atma Samstham Manakrutva, Atma Samstham Manakrutva, Nakinchidapichin, Atma Samstham. So fixing it in the self, Manaha, Atma Samstham Manaha, Supistaha, Nanka Bahistaha, self-produced in the notes, because it's a very, very important sutram. This is also Upapada Samasa, of course, but this is 324. Lanka Bahistaha. Lanka Bahistaha. Bahistaha. So this is the sutram Supistaha. And of course use Atolopitich. Okay, this was the summary. Now let's take one shloka, Pratama shloka. This was only, again, I'm sorry it took so long this time. It is a very long adhyaya. It won't be this long next time around. So it'll be only one line, or maybe tops two lines most of the time. So mostly one line only. So okay, you want to try this one? Ranjit, try this one.
Can we read the two lines first, like the Sanskrit lines?
Yes. Tato Ravana Nitayaha Sitayaha Shatrukarshanaha Ato Shatrukarshanaha Pashaveda Yesh Padamanveshtum Charanacharite Pati. One more time. Tato Ravana Nitayaha Sitayaha Shatrukarshanaha Yesh Padamanveshtum Charanacharite Pati. Okay. Padachyada Ravi?
Tataha Ravana Nitayaha Sitayaha Shatrukarshanaha Yesha Padam
Anveshtum
Charana Charite Pathi.
Pathi. Some quick grammar for you. I know it's too much grammar today, Ravi, for today. Pathi. Sutam for Pathi.
Pathi. It's Saptami Ekavachanam for Pathin.
Very good. Very good. For Tilopa. This is the one sutram which is outside the Bhashyadikara. It's a Bhakaryam. Bhasambandikaryam. It's the one sutram that we know, Ravi, which is outside the Bhashyadikara. We just the karyam Vishnu Bhasanya. Bhasyate lopaha. Bhasyate lopaha. Bhasyate lopaha. Means that is pathi, mathi, rabakshin. Bhasanya kanam tihilopavati pathi. Comes in Gita. Vivudo Brahman of Pathi, chapter 6 of Gita. So when this pathi nangam, and some others also, a couple others, has the bhasanya, takes tihilopaha. This is the one sutram, Ravi, which is outside the Vasyadikara, because of the Anuruti Suvidartham. Anuruti Panini likes the Anuruti there, so he pushes sutram outside the Vasyadikara. But this is because Anuruti is coming down of the Pathi Mati Rivukshin, so that Anuruti is coming down. So it is the Pathi Mati Rivukshamat. So because otherwise, repeat all this again, the Vasyadikara will be too much. So Panini says, I'll take this sutram and put outside the Vasyadikara, Anuruti can be used over here. Vasyate lopaha. So Pathi is there. How about Yesha?
Yesha is Ishu Ichayam.
Very good. અને સ્ત્રી વટ લકાર
સે લિટ લકાર પ્રથમ પુરુષ આ એક વચન
વેરી ગુડ યેશ યેશ બલરામજી વોટ્સ ધ ટ્રાન્સલેશન વોટ ઇઝ ફોર યેશ
વોટ ધ ટ્રાન્સલેશન વિશ ટુ
યસ વિશ ટુ વેરી ગુડ હી વિશ ધેટ ધેટ્સ ધ ટ્રાન્સલેશન વિશ ટુ હો નો કેન યુ ફિલ ઇન ધ ગેપ્સ ઓફ ધ યર યેશ ફ્રોમ ફ્રોમ
ધ ડેરિવેશન
નો ડેરિવેશન યા હા સો ધાતુ વિશ પ્લસ લિટ ઇઝ અભ્યાસઃ becomes not to because we'll go in short now become e even before the abhyasa even before abhyasa comes an issue right so when you have to when you have okay when you have ish pratyaya came tip became null first lit came lit la became tip became null by null atus us thal atus null vama ha so in the lit lakara prasya padanam Parasmipada Pratyaya became, they get this outside substitution, outright substitutions, outright, means there is no sarvadeshaha. So in Litlakaraha, they all change. And Litlakara mostly third person, so when null atusus become outright, tiptajji becomes null atuspus. So what's the issue now here, Ravi, is that I want to do gunaha of this ikaraha.
But dirvachanechi.
Very good. Dirvachanechi. Dirvachan means abhyase. Dirvachane. So, kartavye ajyadesho na. Ajyadesha. Where is the sutra? Dirvachanechi. 159. So, basically that don't do the ajyadesha. Dirvachane dvitya kartavye. So, 158 you have to wait to do that. So, then we can do abhyasa. Which is Hathur and Abhyasas. Yep. So we can do that. So now what do we get that? We get, of course, Saladish Sheshaha. E. Now we can do Guna now. Now we can do Guna of this one and make it. Akuchutu Halantyam. So we done the Lichid Hathur and Abhyasas. Then Saladish Sheshaha. And now what's the last step?
Now Abhyasas Yasavarne.
Very good. I'm impressed, Ravi. Good job. Yes. Because normally Yan Sandhi wants to come Abhyasasya Savarne. Abhyasas, what number will that be?
It's a young one, Adisha.
Very good. So after, below is 6478. Achinzatu Bhruvam, you were young one gau Abhyasasya Savarne. So 6478. Okay, good. Good, Ravi. That's good. You're getting this Tinganta. You can be Tingant Samrat. For the next year and a half, new Padavi you got today. For the next year and a half, Ravi is going to think and prakaran. So it's a chance for you to teach us so that then you can learn the best. You can only learn when you teach somebody else, Ravi. This is your chance to, you know, to teach. So Iyesha means that he wished. He wished. That's the Kriyapadam. Iyesha. Okay. Let's go back to Balaram. Let's see what we have now. Now, in order to discover, what do you think, Balaramji?
Charana Charite?
Anveshtum.
Oh, Anveshtum. I thought two course through the heavens might be Anveshtum.
Yeah, because we're going to, there's a bit of a problem here, by the way. There's a small problem here. But let's take it. Let's do what all we can do.
Okay.
Discover. The thing, there, Balaram, is that the Anu plus ish is to search.
Yeah, it came earlier also.
Yes, it did.
In the first paragraph, yeah. Anveshtum. Sitam Anveshtum, I guess.
Anveshtum, very good. So Anvish, Anu ish is to search, to seek out. If you knew that, then you could probably get the form, right? So Anvish is to search, Anvish. To seek, to search, to look for. So Anveshtum is Tumunanta Pratyaha. So Ravi now, Anveshtum, again Tumun Pratyaya, right Ravi? Tumun. The same, Kriya Thayam Kriyayam. In order to search for Sita, he wished to go into the sky, to course through the sky. Anyway, let's continue. In order to discover is Anveshtum. Now, the whereabouts of Sita.
Charana Charite. Pati is Sita, I guess.
No, Sita Yaha is Sita, of Sita. Shashti ekavacham Sitaya of Sita. It's a very fun exercise, Balaram, very fun exercise. What you can do is that you can just like strike out, you like match the columns, you know. It's like match the columns. Because you have the whole Gita, whole Ramayanam, whole Bhagavad Gita, match the columns. You have 44,000 verses of match the columns. By the time you're done with it, yeah, I think you're done. So Sita Yaha is of Sita. Now, how about the whereabouts? What's left now? What is left now? Tataha is left. Ravananita is left.
Shatrukarshana and Charana Charita is left.
No, Padam is Padam. Padam Anveshtum, Padam.
Oh, Padam. Oh.
Ah, that's the whereabouts. Padam Anveshtum.
Okay. I thought Charana must be history, so I thought something there.
Charana is the, you know, Deva Vishesha, Devata. They're the kind of gods, some kind of gods. Oh. It's qualifying Pathi. So it is Saptami Ekavachanam qualifying Pathi. But Padam Anveshtum is to discover the whereabouts. Yeah. Padam is the karma of Anvishum. Anvishum, okay. Of Sita. Now the Sita has an adjective. Who had been taken away by Ravana?
Taken away by Ravana. Nitya, Nitaya.
Nitaya.
I think Nitaya is taken away.
Very good. What is Dhatu there?
Ni, nu or ni?
Ni.
Ni.
Nitaha. Anitam.
Prapani.
Nim Prapani. Very good. So Ravi, what kind of samasa is for samasa, Ravi?
This is Tritiya Tatpurusha Ravanena Nita, Ravanena Nita.
Very good. Ravanena Nita. When the sutra for me, Ravi, quickly.
Tritiya.
Kattukarne Kutabahulam. The Kattu or Karana, the doer of the instrument, can be compounded with the Kudanta Padam in many ways, which is good. It is very good. Asmakam Subhidha Jata. So Bahula Grahanena. So Kattukarani Kuta Bahulam. In this case, just we don't need Bahulam over here. What I'm saying is that the Kattu or the Karana can be compounded. Where is that one? Here it is. Can be compounded with the Kudantam. Very common compound. Very, very common compound. Rama Hataha. Bana Hataha. How about two of them? Kattukarane. So Wali. Rama Hataha Wali. Bana Hataha Api Wali. So Wali is Ramena Hataha Bali, Wali, and then also Banina Hataha Api Wali. So Kartu is Ramaha, Karana is the Banaha. Then make Rama Hata, Bana Hata, Kartu Karane. This is the Prathama Dhyuvachanam, Ravi. Kartu Karane. Krutaya Sitya Ekavachanam. So these can be compounded with Kudantam Padam Bahulam. So very common usage. So again, Ravanena Nitayaha. Is Kattukarani Kuta Bahulam, I guess time's out for 2132. Ravana Nita. 2132 Purusha. Ravana Nita. Ravana Nita. Ravana Nita. 32. Ravana Nita. Uh-huh. Okay, now the last part is that what's left now? Hanuman, the scourge of his foes. What is that?
Shatru Karshanaha.
Karshanaha.
Why is it in brackets?
Because Hanuman is not there in the verse.
Oh, I see.
So he is being referred to Bahu. What kind of compound is this, Ravi?
Shatrunam Karshanaha.
Very good. Shatrunam Karshanaha. Now this Dhatu Krish Ravi is Talavya Shakaranta, Mudana Shakaranta. Now can give me different meanings, Ravi, of this Dhatu?
Krusha Vilekhane.
So Krishna Vileka, that is the Mudhanya.
Okay.
And what is the Talavya? It comes in Vishnu, who chanted Vishnu Sahasranama Sotram? You chanted Vishnu Sahasranama Sotram? Vishnu Sahasranama Sotram? Krishna Sthulo. Krishna Sthulo. Which Shakara there, Balaram? Which Shakara is there? The Mudhanya Talavya. It's the Talavya Shakara there. Krishna in the sense of Talavya means to be weak. To be emaciated. Mudhanya is to draw, to pull, to plow, to also to torture. So both will work over here. One who weakens his enemies, one who kind of tortures enemies, one who tortures. So let's see what Ravi gave us was the Krishna from Vilekhane, Ravi. That's the Mudana, Ravi. The Talavya Tanukarane. We just had it, Tanukarane. We just had it.
Tanukarane. Yes.
Tanukarane. The Tanukarane Divadigana. And Vilekhane is Sudadi Bhadi. Now, my Shloka and Gita, by the way. And a lot of times they can be overlapping meanings. You know? So a lot of this part of it which you see over here can come in other places also. This, because they, you know, one is to make weak, one is to torture. So they kind of a little bit overlap. In Gita, Shloka, Manche Vada Sairastham, it comes in Gita, chapter 17. Manche Vada Sairastham, Kashyantaha. Comes in Gita. Chapter 17, so torturing me or weakening me, same thing there also. In Gita also same thing, same issue there also. Isn't Satvika Devan, Mamchai Vanta Shairastham, Karshyanta, yeah, so Karshyanta Shairastham, Bhuta Gramam Chetasaha, so Karshyanta Shairastham, Mamchai Vanta Shairastham, means they torture me in the body, but in the Tamasik Tapaha, these people of the Asuri Sampatti, they torture me in the body. Kashyantaha mam, Shairastham. Again, Ravi, Shairastham, look at it, we got one more. Shairastham, Supistaha, Shairastham, mam, Kashyantaha. You know, so part of it is here. They weaken me in the body, or they torture me. Same thing here. Pratyaya, another way from Ravi, Karshanaha, Pratyaya, Liu, which sutram for this, Ravi? But like Ramanaha, Lamana.
Nandi Grahi Pachadibhyo Yunin Yachaha.
Very good, thank you. So Yunin Yachaha. Pratya is used as Ramanaha, Vibhishanaha. So these are all coming in this sutram. Nandi, Nandiyaji Dhatu Sri Pratya Liu. Nandanaha. So, and your time is up, so let me put in short. So Karishanaha, to the Pugandalupas Guna. The Pugandalukupadashi Gunaha, and then of course Yuvaranakau. So 3-3, so 3-1-1-34. Let's do the translation. We'll do some maybe detail next time. Alright, so Karshanaha, or also make it Karshanaha. So get used to this one, get used to this. This comes a lot. Karshanaha. It become 3-1-1-34 you used, sorry, 134, then you used, you know, you were an akau, we can make it ana, and then of course natam in the second case, 8-4-2, okay, 8-4-2, natam in the second case only, Karshanaha. Alrighty, so let's finish up now. So, wish to, now how about this one, to course? To the heaven.
Pati is the only one left.
Yeah, Pati is left. So you have to supply Gamanaya. Pati Gamanaya is. Look at the commentary now. Let's bring at the commentary. When we have now, at this point, look at the commentary now. And the first Tilaka commentary says, very first commentary, he says that, let's see what they have to say. He says, Pati. Akasha marge gamanaya iyesha. Gamanaya iyesha. So, you know, that's what he says. So, and the other one says that iyesha praptumiti sheshaha. Praptumiti sheshaha. Means he wished to reach the sky or he wished to course through the sky. So, this is from the commentary. This is understood. Gamanaya. Then through the heavens, this is the pathi, is the path which is frequented by these charanas. Acharite, sevite. So charana acharite, if you look at the commentary, charana is a kind of gods, they are the heavenly, I think, musicians. Charanaihi deva jati visheshaihi. Deva jati visheshaihi. Charanaihi deva jati visheshaihi. I think Govinda Raja gives Deva Gayakaha Charanaha. Deva Gayakaha. Anyway, so this is, what kind of compound quickly, Ravi? What kind of compound? Same thing.
Tritiya Tatpurusha?
Same sutram. कर्तृकरणे कृता बहुलम, कर्तृकरणे कृता बहुलम, सो चारणैः ही आचरिते पथियो, सो इन द पाथ व्हिच इज फ्रीक्वेंटेड बाय और सर्विस्ड बाय टेकन टू बाय द चारणास मींस इन द स्काई, दिस ऑल मींस इन द स्काई बेसिकली, दिस थिंग, दिस होल थिंग मींस द स्काई, आकाशे, because it is a path which is frequented by, served by the charanas. So through the heavens is this charana chitapati, is the path, is the puspati of the charanas celestial barge. Okay, let's stop with that now. Thank you, Balamji. Thank you, Ravi. And next time, okay, let me give the numbers for them. Next time, you will take these five sutras, shlokas here. Yes, there are some number differences, okay? So, Eva Muktaha Kapishesha, this is, I think, 5130 in the Gita Press edition. Gita Press 130, and then also 169, we also take up, we take up two more also, we'll see, next, well, at least for next time, 130, 169. So, we try these two for next time, okay, and we will take two more also next time, okay. Ramo Rajamanis Tada Vijayate Ramam Rameshum Vijay Ramena Vihata Nishashara Rama Nasti Parayanam Paratram Ramasya Dasam Rame Chittale Sada Bhutame Bho Rama Mamudhara Rama Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Mano Rame Sahasra Nama Tatulyam Rama Nama Varandane Shri Rama Nama Varandana Om Namasti. You doing okay, Vastu?
Yeah, we are okay.